Want to speak real Turkish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at TurkishClass101.com.
Hello everyone, I'm Selin from TurkishClass101.com. Today we're going to talk about 10 ways to remember words. Tekrar etme. To repeat. Tekrar etme. Tekrar etme. To repeat. Benden sonra tekrar edin. Repeat after me. So I think repeating helps a lot because not just the words, actually, you can repeat the sentences again and again, so you will remember it easily. And because the situations are actually pretty similar, like you talk with someone, they ask you where you're from, like this, and the situation always repeats itself. I mean, the same situation with different people. So if you just repeat the sentences all the time, you memorize it and you can use it more fluently next time. Alt yazılı dizi izlemek. Watching TV series with subtitles. Alt yazılı dizi izlemek. Alt yazılı dizi izlemek. Watching TV series with subtitles. Çok fazla alt yazılı dizi izlediğim için kelime dağarcığım belirgin şekilde gelişti. My vocabulary has developed significantly because I was watching a lot of TV series with subtitles. Actually, that's what I'm doing to learn a foreign language and it helps me a lot. I'm watching a lot of TV series. Maybe it's not something good, but it helps me to learn a language. Actually, there are so many Turkish TV dramas now, also worldwide famous. I'm sure you can find it easily on the internet. Muhteşem Yüzyıl, which is Magnificent Century. It's about the Ottoman Empire. It's pretty famous as far as I heard, like in Russia, in Middle East. So maybe you can check that out. But the language could be a bit hard for you actually because it's like the old times. But just do your best. It's also a very fun TV series. So, yazarak çalışmak. Practice by writing. Yazarak çalışmak. Practice by writing. Kelimelerin doğru yazılışlarını öğrenmek için yazarak çalışmak şart. Practice by writing is a must in order to learn the right spelling of words. Practicing by writing, it might be a bit time consuming, I agree with that. But when you write something so many times, then you can remember it easily. For example, languages like Japanese, Russian, they have different alphabets. They have like kanji, for example. And it's really hard to learn if you cannot write. So same goes for Turkish. When you write a word many times and many times, it's going to be easy for you to remember. It's going to come out your mind easily. That's why I think it's a good way to learn a language. Yüksek sesle okumak. Reading out loud. Yüksek sesle okumak. Reading out loud. Akıcı konuşabilmek için her gün yüksek sesle okuma alıştırması yapıyorum. To be able to speak fluently, I practice reading out loud every day. So, reading out loud, it just doesn't help you learn a language, but also it helps you with your diction. Helps you to sound more like a native speaker. It is also a very, very helpful way to learn a foreign language, especially speaking part. Hikaye uydurmak. Making up stories. Hikaye uydurmak. Making up stories. Kelimelerin anlamları ile ilgili hikaye uydurmak hatırlamaya yardımcı olur. Making up stories about the meanings of the words helps you remembering what the words mean. Sometimes, for example, when I make a presentation in another language, I'm writing my own speech, so I'm remembering all the time, and it helps me memorize a language too at the same time. So, yeah, I think it's really nice to make up your own stories. It's going to be easier to remember. Dinleyerek ezberlemek. Memorize by listening. Dinleyerek ezberlemek. Memorize by listening. Benim işitsel hafızam daha kuvvetli olduğundan kelimeleri dinleyerek ezberlemek benim için daha kolay. Since I have a strong auditory memory, it is easier for me to memorize words by listening. Do you remember the other one we talked, like watching TV series with subtitles? So when you watch it, when you watch the subtitles, of course, you also listen the drama, right? So it's gonna help you to remember. Actually, you will be doing both of them together. You will listen, you will read the subtitles, and you will learn the language. Kelimeler arasında bağlantı kurmak. Creating associations between words. Kelimeler arasında bağlantı kurmak. Creating associations between words. Bu kelimeleri hiç unutmuyorum çünkü kelimeler arasında bağlantı kurarak ezberledim. I never forget these words because I have memorized them by creating associations between words. So you can create associations based on your daily life, for example, or something you have experienced. So this happened, the girl name was this, it relates to this, like this kind of relationship. Try to find examples from your own life. Basit metinler okumak. Reading simple texts. Basit metinler okumak. Seviyeme uygun basit metinler okumak yabancı dil öğrenmeme yardımcı oluyor. Reading simple texts that are suitable for my level helps me learn foreign languages. So I tried that before actually. I downloaded an application. It was like the more like easy way to read a newspaper actually. Normally the words are a bit more hard to understand, but they made it easier for like beginner level like people, and it really helped me actually. So maybe you can also download these kind of applications that can help you to learn Turkish. So first you will read like more easy versions, and then you can just read like a normal newspaper later. Türkçe sözlü şarkı dinlemek. Listening to songs with Turkish lyrics. Türkçe sözlü şarkı dinlemek. Listening to songs with Turkish lyrics. Bazı öğrenciler Türkçe sözlü şarkılar dinleyerek yeni kelimeler öğreniyorlar. Some students learn new words by listening to songs with Turkish lyrics. I like Turkish rock music actually, so I'm going to give you some examples. You can listen to their songs. But I know some songs are very hard to understand, so please don't feel bad about that. The first group is MFÖ. They are pretty old actually, but they are one of the like legends in Turkey. And they have very, very nice songs and very easy to understand if you ask me. Also, there is one more band. They say like they are a Turkish Linkin Park. It is Manga. Yeah, just like Japanese word, manga. And some songs are very hard to understand, I know, because they rap sometimes, so it's really fast. But some of their songs are very nice and very easy to understand. Maybe you can check them out. Uykuya yatmadan önce tekrar etmek. Repeat before sleeping. Uykuya yatmadan önce tekrar etmek. Repeat before sleeping. Uykuya yatmadan önce tekrar etmek, yeni bilgilerin uzun süreli hafızaya geçmesini sağlıyor. Repeating before going to sleep makes the new information become long-term memories. And actually not just for a foreign language. I also did this when I studied, like when I was studying to any of my lessons. I just read it once and then I sleep. Then it really helps me to remember next day. I did it for all my exams, and I think it works. It's a really nice way to learn a foreign language. I think you should try it too. Okay, that's it for today. I know today we learned a bit long sentences, and maybe it's going to be hard for you to remember for the first time. But if you watch this video many, many times, then I'm sure it's going to be much more easier for you to remember. So please subscribe our channel if you want to watch more videos like that. And please visit our website, turkishclass101.com. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!
Want to learn Turkish anywhere, anytime? Get the Innovative Language 101 app for free.
Hi everyone, it's Celine, and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Yay! Today, we're going to speak Turkish together. Okay, let's start. I'm really excited about the topic, so let's go and see. Fruits! Yay, finally about fruits. I'm so happy, fruits. I really like fruits. Meyveler in Turkish. If you want to say fruit, then it's meyve. Meyve is fruit. Meyveler, plural form, is fruits. Yeah, simple, right? Meyve. Ananas. Pineapple. I think I really like ananas. And did you know, like, if you eat ananas, then it helps you lose weight? Yeah, I checked a lot. I searched a lot about it. It doesn't grow in Turkey. Yeah, like, not everyone is eating, or it's not so popular in Turkey, maybe. Ananas kilo vermene yardımcı olur, which means pineapple helps you lose weight. It's important, right? Kavun, melon. I think it's my, sorry, but least favorite fruit. I don't know why. I'm sorry, kavun. I really don't like you. So my example is, of course, kavunu sevmiyorum. I don't like melon. Sevmiyorum means I don't like, I don't love. So I don't like melon. Kavunu sevmiyorum. I said it so dramatically, maybe. Kavunu sevmiyorum. No, like, maybe it sounds better like that. Kavunu sevmiyorum. Elma. Apple. Oh, it's cute, right? It's, I don't know why did I say cute to a fruit. I think apple is cute. In old times, in Turkey, maybe in, like, in Turkish villages, if you have someone you love, but you're just too shy to show your love. And in old times in Turkey, it was kind of, how should I say, not so okay to show your love. So the girl was giving an apple to a guy. It means, I love you. So if the girl just gives the apple to the guy, understands, oh, maybe this girl has feelings for me, maybe like that. Her gün elma yemek sağlığınız için çok iyidir. It means, like, eating apple every day is good for your health. Çilek. Strawberry. Oh, that's my favorite. I really like strawberry. Even when I speak about strawberry, I'm so happy. Çilek is awesome. Even, like, the sound is nice, right? Çilek. It's like something even cuter than apple. Çilek. Strawberry. So that is why my example is, of course. Her gün çilek yiyebilirim. I can eat strawberries every day, which is true. Her gün means every day, as I said before. Her gün çilek yiyebilirim. In Turkey, we also have, like, this as a name for girls. Çilek, strawberry. Hey, strawberry, how are you? Hey, çilek. It's really true. Like, some girls are named as, like, çilek in Turkey. Çilek, naber? Naber means, like, hi, how are you, çilek? Like that. Portakal. Orange. I think it's same everywhere in the world, but in Turkey we think if you catch cold or flu, and then if you eat orange, then you'll be get well soon. Maybe that's why I kind of don't like it, because, like, every time when I eat orange, portakal, I remember the old times when I got sick. Oh, every time when I got sick, I had to eat orange because my family just pushed me to eat orange. It reminds me kind of being sick. I'm sorry. Oh, so yeah, let's give example like that. If you catch flu, then just eat orange. Eğer grip olursanız, portakal yiyin. Okay, thank you guys for watching the video. Today we talked about fruits, which is my, I think, favorite topic. So I told you my favorite fruit and my least favorite fruit. So what are your favorites and which fruits you, like, you don't like or you dislike? Just tell me. And if you want to watch more videos or if you want to learn Turkish, then please visit turkishclass101.com. See you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Hi everyone, it's Celine. And today we're going to do Turkish weekly words. And I'm going to be teaching you some useful Turkish words that you can use in your daily life and so. So let's start. Okay, so today's topic is hobbies. Yay. In Turkish, actually, we also say hobby. So it's really close to English word. And I like to talk about hobbies, actually. I have so many hobbies. I'm so proud of it. Well, let's see the first word. Çizmek. To draw, yeah. I'm really bad at drawing, but let me give you a good example about it. Resim çizmeyi çok seviyorum. Resim çizmek is drawing a picture. Resim is picture. Resim çizmeyi çok seviyorum. Yeah, I really like to draw a picture as well, but since I'm really bad at it, I just don't draw anything. Nette surf yapmak. Surf the net. Net is net in Turkish as well. And surf is surf. I think it's pretty close. And yapmak is like to do the activity itself. So nette surf yapmak. Her gün nette surf yapıyorum. It's like I am surfing the net every day. Of course, I'm not doing. No, it's not true, but... Bir müzik aleti çalmak. Play a musical instrument. I really like that because I can also play something. I can play piano, so I'm going to give example about it. Ben piyano çalıyordum. It means like I was playing piano in the past. Satranç oynamak. Play chess. I did that too. Satranç oynamak. But of course, like... You should speak fast, right? So you should say satranç oynamak. I know you can do. I used to play chess actually when I was in middle school. So I was really bad at it too. I don't know why. I was really bad at everything. I tried. Anyway, if you want to ask, do you play chess? Then you go like satranç oynar mısın? Yüzmek. Yüzmek. It means swim. Swimming. Yeah, it's my favorite hobby. So that's why I picked it. You can say like havuzda mı? Yüzersin denizde mi? Would you prefer to swim in pool or in sea? Havuzda mı yüzersin denizde mi? Well, personally, I prefer pool. I'm such a princess, maybe. Thank you guys for watching. Today we talked about hobbies. So just let us know what are your favorite hobbies in comments below. If you want to watch more videos or if you want to learn Turkish, then please visit turkishclass101.com. I'll be waiting. Okay, see you guys. Hi everyone, it's Celine and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. As usual, I don't know the content of the lesson, so it's a surprise for me. Let's find out together. Colors. Renkler. Colors mean renkler. Kırmızı. Red. Red is my absolute favorite color. Kırmızı bir ruj almak istiyorum. Which means, I wanna buy a red lipstick. Sarı, yellow. Türkiye'de taksiler sarıdır. Taxis in Turkey are yellow. I think in the rest of the world it's yellow as well. In Japan it's green. No, green, white, maybe? Yeah. Oh, but we have pink actually. We have pink taxis, like recently. I wanna ride pink taxi. Mavi, blue. Mavi bir gökyüzü altında uyumak istiyorum. I said, I want to sleep under a blue sky. So poetic, maybe. Mavi bir gökyüzü altında uyumak istiyorum. Yeşil. Green. Green is my second favorite color. En iyi arkadaşımın göz rengi yeşil. My best friend's eye color is green. It is really green. He has really beautiful green eyes. Pembe. Pink. Türkiye'de pembe taksiler de var. In Turkey, there are pink taxis as well. Well, usually it's yellow, but recently we have pink. If you want to watch more videos, please visit turkishclass101.com. So see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Hi everyone, it's Celine, and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Yay! Today, we're going to be talking about... I don't know yet. So let's see. Computer words. No, it's so hard. Oh, okay. How can I translate it? Computer is bilgisayar. Word is sözcük or kelime. Both are fine. So, bilgisayar, sözcükleri. Computer words. Dizüstü, bilgisayarı. Laptop computer. Dizüstü means like above the knee. I don't know why we are saying like that, but we are saying above the knee computer. It's laptop. Dizüstü bilgisayarın var mı? Do you have a laptop computer? But in Turkish, like, I don't know why. Maybe it's because, like, it's too long to say dizüstü bilgisayarı. We also say laptop, but our pronunciation is kind of different. We're saying, like, laptop. Some people say laptop, but some people say laptop, and it's both fine, I guess. Ekran, monitor. Ekran means monitor, but we also use it for, like, to say, like, screen, like television screen or so. If you want to say like televizyon ekranına çok yaklaşma, don't get so close to television screen. And we use that word like ekran. Televizyon ekranına çok yaklaşma. Çok yaklaşma means just don't get so close. So close means like don't get close. Maybe it's like yaklaşmak. Yaklaşma. Televizyon ekranına çok yaklaşma. Niye? Why? Because it's not good for your eyes, I guess. Fare, mouse. In Turkish, fare also means like mouse, I mean that animal, and also like computer stuff. I think I really don't like mouses. Mice, I really don't like mice, yeah. Let me give an example like that. Masanın üstünde fare var. There's a mouse on the table. Masanın üstünde fare var. But which mouse? We don't know. Masa means table and üst means like on. The table means masanın üstünde. Var is like, var is word for there is, there are, like var. Masanın üstünde fare var. Yazıcı, printer. Yazmak means like to write. Yazdırmak means to print. Yazıcı means printer. So we just kind of arrange the verb. We just changed it and made it like yazıcı. Example. Yazıcının mürekkebi bitmiş. Which means there is no ink in the printer or it's like it's over. Mürekkep means ink. So yazıcının mürekkebi bitmiş. Then our last word is hoparlör. Hoparlör, which means speaker. It's important, right? Important to know. And my example is hoparlörün sesini çok açma. Don't make the speaker so loud. Hoparlörün sesini çok açma. Usually Turkish moms say that. So thank you guys for watching the video today. We talked about computer words and I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you just learned something from me. If you want to watch more videos or if you want to learn Turkish, then please visit TurkishClass101.com. I'll be waiting for you. See you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Hi everyone, it's Celine. Merhaba, ben Celine. And welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Nasılsınız? Nasıl gidiyor? The content of the lesson is a surprise for me, so let's find out together. Clothing actions. Okay. Clothing actions. Giymek. Put on. I think we use this word for all kind of clothes and shoes and everything. Bugün lacivert peyimi giydim. I wore my blue shirt today. Yes. Like. Çıkartmak. Take off. We can use for shoes, dresses, clothes or your accessories. Like I'm taking off my watch. Saatimi çıkarıyorum. Şu an saatimi çıkarıyorum. I'm taking off now. Like that. Take off. But you don't use put on for watch. You say saati takmak, not saati giymek. And saati çıkarmak. Saat is watch. Saatimi çıkarıyorum. I'm taking off my watch. Yıkamak. Wash. I hate wash my clothes every day. Her gün kıyafetlerimi yıkıyorum. I wash my clothes every day. It's a big lie. I don't wash my clothes every day. Once in every 3 days, maybe? Kurutmak. Dry. Elbiselerimin kuruması uzun sürdü. It took long time for my clothes to be dried. In cold weathers, maybe. It takes long time for your clothes to dry. Ütülemek. Iron. Do you guys do? I think I don't do usually. I'm bad at irony. Ütü yapmayı sevmiyorum. I don't like ironing. Ütü yapmayı sevmiyorum or ütülemeyi sevmiyorum. Ütü yapmak or ütülemek, both are same. You can use both, it's fine. Thank you guys for watching and see you in the next video. If you want to watch more videos, then please visit turkishclass101.com. Bye bye, görüşürüz. Hi everyone, this is Celine and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. So today, what do you think we'll be talking about? I'm so excited, so let's find out together. At the office, ofiste, masa, desk. Actually, in Turkish, we say sıra for desk. If you're in a school, then you can use sıra. But if you're in an office, then you should say masa instead of sıra. Masamda birçok kağıt var. There are so many papers in my desk. Bilgisayar. Computer. So if you want to say desktop in Turkish, then you go like masa üstü bilgisayar. Benim masa üstü bilgisayarım var. I have a desktop computer. Toplantı. Meeting. There are usually many meetings in companies, right? So yeah, we use the word toplantı. It's very, very common. If you want to complain to your coworkers, like, oh, today's meeting was so long, then you can say in Turkish, like, bugünkü toplantı çok uzundu. İş arkadaşı. Coworker. İş arkadaşlarınla iyi geçiniyor musun? Are you getting along with your coworkers? Maybe like your boss can ask you, right? Are you getting along with your coworker? Müdür. Manager. Boss or manager, we say müdür. There is always a manager in the office, right? Müdürünüz kim? Who's your manager? So thank you for watching the video. If you want to watch more Turkish videos, please visit turkishclass101.com. See you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Hi everyone, it's Celine and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Yay, I'm applauding myself. And today we will be learning rooms. Rooms, really? Rooms? Okay. Oturma odası. Living room. Actually in Turkish, oturma means like sitting down. So it's like sitting down room. Oturma odanız çok temiz. Çok beğendim. It means like, oh, your living room is really clean. I really liked it. Yemek odası. Dining room. In Turkey, I think we don't have like a separate dining room. Usually, maybe like living room, dining room, kind of same for us. Benim evimde yemek odası yok. There is no dining room in my house. Mutfak. Kitchen. Mutfakta vakit geçirmeyi seviyorum. Çünkü yemek yapmayı seviyorum. It's kind of long, right? It means like, I like to spend time in kitchen because I like cooking. Banyo, bathroom. I like to be in bathroom. We also say like, take bath, taking bath. Bath is banyo, so we are using the same word. Banyo yapmak, taking bath. Or for bathroom, banyo. Banyoda ayağım kaydı. Which means, my foot slipped in the bathroom. Çamaşır odası. Laundry room. Turkish housewives use that kind of room for like cleaning, doing laundry and ironing, that kind of stuff. So not every house has this kind of room, but sometimes I see that kind of room in some houses. We don't have. We have a really small house, like 3 people only. So we don't have. So thank you guys for watching today. Videomu izlediğiniz için çok teşekkür ederim. See you guys in the next video, I hope. If you want to watch more videos or if you want to learn Turkish, then you have to visit turkishclass101.com. Mutlaka bekliyorum. Kesinlikle gelin. I'm waiting for you. Like, let's learn Turkish together. So, yeah. See you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Merhaba. Hi, everyone. It's Celine. Ben Celine. Nasılsınız? Welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. We don't know the content of the lesson yet. Let's find out together. In your wallet, cüzdanında. Wallet means cüzdan. In your wallet is cüzdanında. So we're talking about that. Okay. Nakit para. Cash. Nakit para. Cash. I don't have it in my wallet. ATM'den nakit para çektim ve cüzdanıma koydum. ATM'den nakit para çektim ve cüzdanıma koydum. I withdraw money from ATM and I put in my wallet. I said. ATM is ATM. Kredi kartı. Credit card. Kredi kartı. Bankalar kredi kartı vermek istiyor. Which means banks usually try to give credit cards. I mean to customers. Kupon. Kupon. Kuponunuz varsa indirim alabilirsiniz. Kuponunuz varsa indirim alabilirsiniz. If you have coupon, then you can get discount. Ehliyet. Driver's license. I'm not a very good driver. I think many people prefer cars, especially in Istanbul. Ehliyetim var ama araba süremiyorum. Ehliyetim var ama araba süremiyorum. I have driver's license, but I cannot drive. Anahtar. Key. Key. Anahtar. This is the key for my house. So, evimin anahtarı. My house key. Key. And so, what do I have in my wallet? This is my wallet. It looks good on me, right? So, what do I have? Money, cash, coins. Coins, can you hear? That's all for this video. If you want to watch more videos, please visit TurkishClass101.com. See you guys in the next video. Görüşürüz. Bye bye.
Hi everyone, I'm Gabriella. How are your Turkish listening skills? In this video, you'll have a chance to test them out with a quiz. First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Bir erkek ve kız öğrenci ders programlarına bakarak konuşuyorlar. Erkek öğrencinin toplantı günündeki programını seçin.
Gelecek grup sunumumuz hakkında bir toplantı yapmamız gerekiyor.
Tamam, ne zaman boşsun?
Ben okula pazartesi, çarşamba ve perşembeleri geliyorum.
O zaman çarşamba veya perşembe İkimiz için de uygun olur. Çünkü ben de salı, çarşamba ve perşembeleri buradayım. Perşembe öğleden sonra nasıl o zaman?
Perşembe 3. periyoda kadar dersim var. 3. periyottaki ekonomi dersinden sonra olabilir. Fakat ondan sonra saat 5'te part-time işim var. Yani yalnızca 1 saat boşum.
O da biraz kısa. Çarşamba nasıl o zaman?
2. periyottaki çağdaş tarih ve 4. periyottaki uluslararası hukuk dersleri dışında boşum.
Peki, benim de 3. periyotta Asya tarihi ve akşamda part-time işim var. Sabah erkenden buluşup 2. periyot başlayana kadar konuşmaya ne dersin?
Sabahları uyanamıyorum ben. Neden perşembe buluşmuyoruz? Part-time işimi başka bir güne ayarlarım.
Peki. O zaman dersin bittikten sonra kafeteryaya gel. Erkek öğrencinin toplantı günündeki programını seçin. Bir erkek ve kız öğrenci ders programlarına bakarak konuşuyorlar. Erkek öğrencinin toplantı günündeki programını seçin.
Gelecek grup sunumumuz hakkında bir toplantı yapmamız gerekiyor.
Tamam, ne zaman boşsun?
Ben okula pazartesi, çarşamba ve perşembeleri geliyorum.
O zaman çarşamba veya perşembe ikimiz için de uygun olur. Çünkü ben de salı, çarşamba ve perşembeleri buradayım. Perşembe öğleden sonra nasıl o zaman?
Perşembe 3. periyoda kadar dersim var. 3. periyottaki ekonomi dersinden sonra olabilir. Fakat ondan sonra saat 5'te part-time işim var. Yani yalnızca 1 saat boşum.
O da biraz kısa. Çarşamba nasıl o zaman?
2. periyottaki çağdaş tarih ve 4. periyottaki uluslararası hukuk dersleri dışında boşum.
Peki, benim de 3. periyotta Asya tarihi ve akşamda part-time işim var. Sabah erkenden buluşup 2. periyot başlayana kadar konuşmaya ne dersin?
Sabahları uyanamıyorum ben. Neden perşembe buluşmuyoruz? part-time işimi başka bir güne ayarlarım.
Peki, o zaman dersin bittikten sonra kafeteryaya gel.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. Hi everyone, I'm Gabriella. How are your Turkish listening skills? In this video, you'll have a chance to test them out with a quiz. First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Bir karı ve koca bazı kat planlarına bakıyorlar. Hangi daireye bakacaklar? Bu nasıl? Güzel, geniş bir oturma odası var.
Büyük oturma odasının olması güzel ama ben park yeri istiyorum.
Peki, ya bu nasıl?
Aa, bu güzel. Bunu gidip görelim mi?
Bir saniye, dolap biraz fazla küçük değil mi?
Haklısın. Tam aradığımız gibi bir ev yok gibi. Bir dakika, buna ne dersin?
İhtiyacımız olan her şeye sahip, değil mi? Ayrıca dolap da oldukça büyük. Hadi gidip bunu görelim.
Tamam.
Hangi daireye bakacaklar? Bir karı ve koca bazı kat planlarına bakıyorlar. Hangi daireye bakacaklar? Bu nasıl? Güzel, geniş bir oturma odası var.
Büyük oturma odasının olması güzel ama ben park yeri istiyorum.
Peki, ya bu nasıl?
Aa, bu güzel. Bunu gidip görelim mi?
Bir saniye, dolap biraz fazla küçük değil mi?
Haklısın. Tam aradığımız gibi bir ev yok gibi. Bir dakika, buna ne dersin?
İhtiyacımız olan her şeye sahip, değil mi? Ayrıca dolap da oldukça büyük. Hadi gidip bunu görelim.
Tamam.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time.
Want to speak real Turkish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at turkishclass101.com. Hi everyone, do you know how to say I love you in Turkish? In this lesson, you'll learn three different ways to say it. Let's start with how to express your feelings to your loved one.
Seni seviyorum. Seni seviyorum. Seni seviyorum.
Or, if you want to explain those butterflies in your stomach, you can say
Senden hoşlanıyorum. Senden hoşlanıyorum. Senden hoşlanıyorum.
And when you feel that I love you is not enough, you can say
Sana olan sevgimi kelimelerle tarif edemem. Sana olan sevgimi kelimelerle tarif edemem. Sana olan sevgimi kelimelerle tarif edemem.
Hey guys, merhaba, nasılsınız? Welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. The lesson is a surprise for me. I don't know what I'm going to talk about because like it's a surprise, as I told you. So let's find out together. Months of the year. Yılın ayları. Başlayalım. Let's start. Eylül. September. We actually use this word as like a girl name in Turkish. There are some Turkish girls whose name is September. We use it, yeah. And I think it's a pretty name actually. Eylül adında bir arkadaşım var. I have a friend whose name is Eylül. June. Haziran. I like summertime. Maybe it's because I was born in summer. So June is kind of my favorite. Not my favorite, my second favorite after my birthday. Haziran'da hava çok sıcaktır. Weather is very hot in June. Aralık. December. So it's Christmas time, maybe, right? But we don't celebrate Christmas. Oh, it's too bad, right? We celebrate New Year, actually, but we don't celebrate December 25. Aralık'ta, İstanbul'da kar yağar. In December, it snows in Istanbul, but it doesn't snow at all in where I came from, Antalya. Ocak. January. My mom's birthday, January 27. Yeah, I'm not gonna say her age. Maybe she'll be angry. Ocak'ta annemin doğum günü var. My mom's birthday is in January. Ağustos. August. And my birthday is in August. Remember well. Benim doğum günüm 16 Ağustos'ta. My birthday is August 16. And I'm a Leo. Actually, I don't believe in, but I'm a Leo. Yeah. I think that's all for this video. And if you want to watch more videos, please visit TurkishClass101.com. See you guys in the next video. Görüşürüz. Kendinize iyi bakın. Take care. Bye-bye. Hi, everybody. I'm Celine from TurkishClass101.com. Do you know what monsters Turkish people are scared of? In this lesson, you'll learn about three scary monsters in Turkey. Let's start with the most popular monster. Gul yabani. Gul yabani. It can be translated as ghoul in English. It's a giant with a long beard and he carries a staff. He hounds travelers and eats human flesh. That sounds pretty scary, right? You might have heard about the next monster. The next one is Al Karısı. Al Karısı. This translates as the woman of red. The woman in red hounds female horses and other women after childbirth. Also, this female spirit hounds babies after they are born. Okay, here's the last monster. Hortlak. Hortlak. Have you heard of this next one? This translates to zombie in English. The Hortlak is a poltergeist that rises from the grave. It's usually the restless spirit of an unhappy dead person. Often the Hortlak can change shape or become invisible. It lives off of blood and eats raw flesh. Let's wrap up this lesson by recapping what we've learned. Listen to the names of each monster and repeat after me. Ghoul. Ghoul yabani. Ghoul yabani. Woman in red. Al Karısı. Al Karısı. Zombie. Hortlak. Hortlak. Well done! Do you know how Turkish people celebrate Halloween? Celebrating Halloween is not a Turkish tradition, but the locals enjoy it with expatriate friends and foreigners. Big parties are thrown at private homes or restaurants. And that's it. You just learned about three of the scariest monsters in Turkey. Now learn Turkish twice as fast by downloading all your PDF cheat sheets, including survival phrases, pickup lines, business etiquette, and more. Check out the description below and go to TurkishClass101.com now. I'll see you next time. Bir dahaki dersimize kadar görüşmek üzere. Cool. Hello everyone, this is Celine and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. So as usual, I don't know the topic of the lesson yet. It's a surprise for me as well. So let's find out together. Solar system. Okay. In Turkish, we say Güneş sistemi. Basically, Güneş means sun. So yeah, solar, same, solar system. Güneş sistemi. Dünya, earth. In English, sometimes you can say earth and sometimes you say world, right? But we don't have different words. We use the same one, dünya. So there are 7 billion people living in the world. Dünyada 7 milyar insan yaşıyor. Gezegen, planet. Gezegen is planet. Planet is gezegen. Well, we used to have 9 planets, but since Pluto is not accepted as planet anymore, we have 8 left, right? So let's say we have 8 planets in our solar system. Güneş sistemimizde 8 gezegen vardır. Mars. Mars. Maybe the pronunciation is a bit different. We don't say Mars, but instead we're saying like Mars. Do you think there are aliens on Mars? Sizce Mars'ta uzaylılar var mı? I said sizce. It's kind of formal, not so formal, but formal way of saying this sentence. If you want to say this sentence to your friend, then you should say sence instead of sizce. Sence Mars'ta uzaylılar var mı? Or sizce Mars'ta uzaylılar var mı? Uzaylı is alien. I think there are, but not in Mars. We are not alone. Kuyruklu yıldız. Comet. Halley's Comet is visible to naked eye from Earth in every 75 to 76 years. So let's say in Turkish. Halley kuyruklu yıldızı her 75 yılda bir çıplak gözle dünyadan görülebilir. Yıldız. Star. Starry night is yıldızlı gece. If it's a starry night, then the weather will be nice tomorrow. Eğer yıldızlı bir gece varsa, yarın hava güzel olacak demektir. Thank you so much for watching. Today we talked about the solar system. And if you guys want to learn Turkish more, if you want to watch more videos, then please visit turkishclass101.com. So see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. There must be aliens for sure. I'm sure. Hey guys, this is Celine and welcome to your Turkish Weekly Word, as usual. I don't know the topic. It's a big surprise for me too. Let's find out together. Medicine. İlaç. Oh, I wonder what kind of words there are. By the way, in Turkish, we don't say taking medicine. We say içmek. We use içmek verb and it means drinking. So we say drinking medicine. Antibiyotik. Antibiotic. Çocukken çok fazla antibiyotik içtim. When I was a child, I took antibiotic a lot. Soğuk algınlığı ilacı. Cold medicine. If you just go to a pharmacy and if you say, oh, I got cold, do you have any cold medicine? Soğuk algınlığı ilacınız var mı? Do you have cold medicine? Or you can use, do you have a medicine for cold? Soğuk algınlığınız için bir ilaç var mı? Soğuk algınlığı için ilacınız var mı? Öksürük şurubu. Cough syrup. Let's say cough syrups have a very sour taste. Öksürük şurubunun çok ekşi bir tadı vardır. Aşı. Vaccine. Aşılar sizi birçok virüsten korur. Vaccines protect you from many viruses. Ağrı kesici. Painkiller. Kesmek means basically killing it or cutting, cut or kill. Kesmek. Ağrı is like pain, hurt. Ağrı kesici is like painkiller. I like painkillers so much. They're a life savior. No, I don't recommend, of course. Okay, I think this is all for today. And thank you guys for watching the video. If you want to watch more videos, please visit turkishclass101.com. See you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.
Is there a medicine that you like?
Medicine I like? Yes, painkiller. Hi everyone, this is Celine and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. So let's find out today's topic. Home tools are my favorite topic. Çekiç, hammer. Çekiç. A hammer is used to drive nails. Çivi çakmak için çekiç kullanılır. Çivi çakmak için çekiç kullanılır. Testere, saw. A saw is used to cut trees. Testere, ağaç kesmek için kullanılır. Which is actually not good, but it's just an example. Tornavida, screwdriver. A screwdriver is a tool for removing screws. Tornavida, çivileri sökmek için kullanılır. Tornavida, çivileri sökmek için kullanılır. Mezura, tape measure. So actually there are two types of tape measures. One of them is made of plastic and more flexible, and the other one is like self-retracting tape measure. So for the plastic one we say mezura, and for the other one we generally use metre. Metre, mezura. So with a tape measure, you can measure your waist. Let's say, with a tape measure, you can measure your waist. Mezurayla belinizi ölçebilirsiniz. I got fat. Alet kutusu. Toolbox. Every Turkish father has a toolbox. I mean, I don't think it's true, but generally. Her Türk babasının bir alet kutusu vardır. So, that's all for today, and thank you guys for watching. If you want to watch more videos, please visit turkishclass101.com. See you. Bye-bye. Hi, everyone. This is Celine, and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. Are you ready to learn Turkish? Then let's find out today's topic. Studying a language. Dil öğrenmek. Yes, that's what we are doing right now. Studying a language. Okumak. Read. I like to read and I like to learn foreign languages actually. Do you know I can speak Japanese somehow? Do you guys like to read? If you want to say, I can speak Turkish, but I cannot read, then you go like that. Türkçe konuşabiliyorum ama okuyamıyorum. Tekrar etmek. Repeat. Yes, you should repeat all these Turkish words, right? That I'm teaching you. So, repeat after me. Okay, if you want to say repeat after me, then you say benden sonra tekrar edin. Repeat after me. Benden sonra tekrar edin. Ders. Lesson. Do you like Turkish lessons? Türkçe derslerini seviyor musunuz? Let's say it more like in natural Turkish. Türkçe derslerini seviyor musunuz? Do you like my Turkish lessons? Yüksek sesle okumak. Read aloud. Yeah, I think it's helpful if you want to learn a Turkish. No, I mean if you want to learn any foreign language. Can you read aloud this sentence?
Bu cümleyi yüksek sesle okuyabilir misin?
Konuşmak. Speaking. How many languages can you speak?
Kaç tane dil konuşabiliyorsun?
I can speak Turkish, English, and German, and Japanese. Hallo, ich bin Celine und ich komme aus der Türkei. Freut mich. How about Japanese? I'm gonna make self-introduction. Are you ready?
Konnichiwa, 私の名前はセリンです。24歳です。ダンスをするのが大好きです。よろしくお願いします。
Yay! So, yes, over! I'm really curious how many languages can you speak, so if you just read a comment below, then I'm gonna read all of them. If you wanna see more videos, please don't forget to visit turkishclass101.com. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!
Hi, everyone. Do you know the 1,000 most useful phrases in Turkish? In this lesson, you'll be able to know all of them. So sit back, relax, and have a cup of tea as you listen and learn.
Banyo nerede?
Affedersin.
Harika.
Rezervasyonum var.
Bu ne kadar? Bu nedir?
Teşekkür ederim.
Gerçekten mi?
Bana bir indirim yapabilir misiniz? Wi-Fi ücretsiz mi?
Ben çeki alabilir miyim? Öneriniz var mı? Bunu deneyebilir miyim?
You just learned the 1,000 most useful phrases in Turkish. And if you're interested in learning more, try learning the core 2,000 word list. With this, you'll understand 95% of the language, and best of all, this is not a joke. Check out the description below and go to TurkishClass101.com now. See you next time.
Hi everyone, how are you? This is Celine, and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. So, what we will learn today? I don't know yet, so do you want to find out together? Let's start. Jobs. Yeah, it's very important, right? Jobs. Job is iş, your job, işin. Mühendis. Engineer. In Turkish, like, it's kind of, for me, hard to say engineer. And my mom always used to make fun of me because I cannot say the word properly. Watch this, mom. I'm saying it properly now. Mühendis. Engineer. Let's be just simple. Let's say I am an engineer. Yeah. How do you say it? I'm an engineer. Ben bir mühendisim. Ben bir mühendisim. I'm an engineer. Ofis çalışanı. Office worker. Ofis çalışanı. Office workers sit in the office all day. Ofis çalışanları her gün ofiste oturmak zorundadır. Ofis çalışanları her gün ofiste olmak zorundadır. Both are okay. Hemşire. Nurse. I always wanted to be a nurse when I was a child. Çocukken hemşire olmak isterdim. Çocukken hemşire olmak isterdim. Yeah, actually I did it. When I was in elementary school, there was like a school festival. And like teacher said, if you guys already have the costume, then I'm gonna give you that role. So who has the nurse costume? Like she asked the class, but I really wanted to be the nurse, even though I didn't have, I said, I have. And then of course my teacher made me the nurse and I told my family that I need a nurse costume and we bought a new one. So I became the nurse. Polis memuru, police officer. If you say police, it's also okay. Police officers catch the criminals. Polisler suçluları yakalar. Polisler suçluları yakalar. Avukat. Lawyer. Avukat is lawyer. Benim avukat bir arkadaşım var. Benim avukat bir arkadaşım var. I have a lawyer friend. Thank you guys for watching the video. If you want to watch more videos, please visit TurkishClass101.com. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. Is there any engineer who is watching this video? Hi everyone, this is Celine and welcome to Turkish Weekly Words. So today we will be talking about your face. Yüzün. Face is yüz. Yüzün. Your face. And our first word is göz, eye. Can you see my eye color? My example is gözlerin çok güzel. Your eyes are very beautiful. It's a compliment. You can say this to a lady, right? In Turkey,
If you want to compliment to a lady that, oh, your eyes are very big, then we use the word eşek gözlü, means donkey eye. Do you know donkey? So it's kind of a good thing. If you say this, then they will be really thankful. They will say, oh, really? Oh, thank you. It's like, oh, senin gözlerin eşek gözleri gibi. Use burun, nose. If you are not happy with your nose, if you think it's too big, then you'll say like, oh, burnum çok büyük. My nose is too big. Dudak, lips. Dudak. Dudak. Dudak. Angelina Jolie'nin çok büyük dudakları var. Değil mi? Katılıyor musunuz? Angelina Jolie has very big lips. Don't you agree? Kaş. Eyebrow. Kaş. Can you see my eyebrows? My friends say my eyebrows are very thin actually, but I like that way. So they say, kaşların çok ince. It means like, oh, your eyebrows are very thin. Yanak. Cheek. For example, if we think that a girl has a very beautiful cheeks, you can say like, oh, yanakları kırmızı kırmızı. Which means, oh, like her cheeks are very red. To emphasize, we say the word twice. Kırmızı kırmızı. So kırmızı is red, so it's like red, red.
Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.